It's Standard English Supplementary 5, When Instant Works. It is a story written by Anna Sewell. Anna Sewell was an English writer of children's classic Black Beauty. Although it has to come to be treated as a children's book, it was originally meant for those who took care of horses. She talks about kindness, sympathy and understanding in the treatment of horses. So this is a short explanation about what is the story about and who was Anna Sewell. Here the Black Beauty refers to the horse. One morning in the autumn, my masters had to go on a long journey. John harnessed me to the new cart. I liked it to pull as it was very light and the high wheels rolled along so smoothly. It was about to rain. The weather was very windy and dry leaves blew across the road. Master John and I went along merrily till we came to the toll gate at the entrance to the low wooden bridge. The river banks were fairly high, so the bridge, instead of rising in the arc over the river, went across just level. In the middle, if the river was full, the water could be nearly up to the foot of the bridge. There were good sturdy rails on both sides, so people were not afraid. The man at the toll gate said that the river was rising fast. He feared it would be a bad night. Many of the fields were already under water. In one low part of the road, the water was halfway up to many knees. But the cart was so good and the master drove gently, so it did not matter. When we got into the town, I had a good wait. Master's business kept him for a long time, so we could not start for home till late in the afternoon. By then, the wind was much stronger and high here. Master said to John that he had never been out in such a bad storm. We went through a wood where great branches were swaying about like twigs and the wind made a terrible rushing sound. "I wish we were out of this wood," said my master. "Yes, sir," replied John. "I hope no branches fall down on us." The words were hardly out of his mouth when there was a groan and a splitting sound. Then an oak tree that had been torn up by the woods came crashing down and fell right across the road in front of us. I will never say I was not frightened off, for I was. I stopped still trembling. Of course, I did not turn around or run away. I was not brought up like that. John jumped out and in a moment was standing by my head. I held my bridle and calmed my nerves. "That was close. What shall we do now?" asked my master. "Well, sir, we can't drive over this big tree and we can't get round it. We must go back to Four Crossways. Then it will be about 6 miles before we get to the wooden bridge again. It will make us late, but Black Beauty is fresh." This happened sometimes when the river was flooding, so Master did not stop. We were going along at a good speed, but the moment my feet touched the ground, first part of the bridge, I felt sure that something was wrong. I dare not go forward. I made a dead stop. "Go on, Beauty," said my master, and gave me a touch of the whip. But I dared not move. He gave me a sharp snap of the whip. I jumped, but I dared not go forward. "There is something wrong, sir," said John. He got down from the cart and came to my head. He took hold of my bridle and tried to lead me forward. "Come on, Beauty, what's the matter?" Just then, the other man, at the toll gate on the other side ran out flashing a torch like a madman. "Ho, ho, ho, stop," he cried. "What's the matter?" shouted my master. "The bridge is broken in the middle. Part of it has been carried away by the flood. If you come any further, you will be in the river." "Thank God," said my master. "You really are a beauty," said John. As he took hold of my bridle and gently turned me round. Of course, I could not tell him what the problem was, but I knew very well that the bridge was not safe. The wind seemed to have settled down. I grew darker and darker, stiller and stiller. I trotted softly along, the wheels hardly making a sound on the soft wet road. Then Master told John that God had given people brains by which they can find things for themselves. He said, however, God had given animals a special knowledge which did not depend on thinking things out and was much quicker to respond to danger. This instinct in animals, he said, he had often saved the lives of men. John had many stories to tell of dogs and horses and the wonderful ways they had saved the lives of people. He thought many people did not take very good care of their animals and or make friends with them as they should do. At last, we got back to Master's house. We saw that all the lights were on. As we came up to the door, Mistress ran out to greet Master. "Are you safe, my dear? Oh, I have been so worried about you. Did you have an accident?" "No, my dear, but if Black Beauty had not been wiser than we were, all of our three would have been drowned at the wooden bridge." They went into the house and I heard no more. John took me to the stable. Oh, what a good supper he gave me that night, and then a really thick bed of straw. I was grateful for everything, for I was tired. So this is a story about the Black Beauty. So the master and the friend is going. So the master John and his friend and the this horse, this Black Beauty, was going to the shopping or somewhere about the business of the master. They were going and they were spending more time. Then the flood was coming. Then they were returning back on the bridge. So the Black Beauty, this horse is not moving forward because it is thinking somewhere else, but he could not tell what has happened there. So the master were trying, we will go that side, we will keep on forwarding, but the horse was not going. Suddenly one man was coming with a torch and telling that the bridge has been broken, and it was on half of the bridge where running through the water. So then he has told that Black Beauty has saved his life and all the three were safe now. Then they were turning the route and they are coming to the house, and mistress were coming. Mistress means the wife of the master is coming out, and she was very shocked, and she was asking whether you people were safe or not. Then he was telling that I was safe because of this Black Beauty only. Then they went inside. This story is the horse is telling about this. So they went inside. Then the horse can't hear anything. Then the friend is, master's friend is taking this horse to the stable and is giving a very good food and giving a very thick bed straw to sleep. He was very happy at that night. And now we'll see about the glossary. Harnessed. Tied the horse to a cart using a strip of leather and metal fittings. Toll gate, a gate across the road or bridge at which travelers must stop and pay. Sturdy, strong, ground, deep sound, bridle, a set of leather straps tied around the neck of the horse to control it. Instant and imitate typical fixed pattern of behavior in animals in response to certain stimuli. A dead stop, a complete and sudden stop.